Hi, it's Menno. I thought I'd give you a quick update because a few things have happened since I put my LGB seashanty up and since I had my interview with Graham Linehan for his channel. I've lost a few friends since, but I'll get into that a bit later. First of all, I wanted to say welcome to all my new subscribers. Thank you so much for subscribing. If anybody hasn't subscribed yet, just hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you get notified when I put new videos up. So I was asked by the LGB Alliance to make a sea shanty that was positive about being lesbian, gay, bisexual. And I looked into the history of sea shanties, and they were written originally for, you know, sailors on ships, the crew. When they were doing heavy work, the sea shanty was all about them doing it in the same rhythm. All the sea shanties have a particular rhythm, like, what do we do with the drunken sailor? What do we do with the drunken sailor? Early in the morning. So obviously it was to keep the spirits up, but also to make sure that whatever they did, it was synchronized. And I like that sense of being a team and camaraderie, and how can we apply that to being same-sex attracted. So wrote the sea shanty, really enjoyed working on it, got some other guys to sing on it. They all wanted to stay anonymous because they didn't want to get any hate for it. And that's sad, you know, that's a really sad thing, I think, that you can't even say, you know, here's a song about same-sex attraction and I'm singing on it, and people go, that's transphobic, which has happened, but we'll get to that in a bit. So yeah, I was really happy to work on that. Now, obviously, I'm aware that there's a lot of stuff out there online about the LGB Alliance being an anti-trans group, a hate organization. Most of that, in my opinion, is just part of what I think is quite an ugly smear campaign. It's a witch hunt. Anyone who doesn't chant the mantras, trans women are women, trans men are men, you know, they get it in the neck. I'm getting it in the neck. Obviously, they've been getting it in the neck for a long time. Yeah, I don't believe any of that. I think they're lovely people, they're good people. Obviously, I've spoken to them. And I think what they're doing is very important to provide a voice for, you know, LGB specific issues, and a home for, you know, people like me who just want to be able to say, I'm a homosexual man. That means I like men, you know, people with penises, without being called anti-trans or a transphobe. So yeah, good for them sticking to their guns when we feel we're no longer represented by those who used to represent us, like Stonewall or news outlets like Pink News. And it looks like I'm not the only one. Overall, the response has been really good, really positive, and people are getting something really positive out of this song. That was the whole point of the sea shanty, so that was really good to see. So I wanted to read out some of the responses that moved me quite a bit. So here's one that says, I am always so proud to stand with my LGB sisters and brothers for not only our voices and rights now, but for the future generation of LGB kids that are now under threat of gender ideology. And I think this raises a good point that obviously for those of us who have been there, done that, you know, we've come to terms with our same-sex attraction, we've come to terms with who we are as people, and now we're a bit older, so we can give back to those younger ones and hopefully make it a little bit easier for them. Here's another one. The first song I've heard that doesn't shy away from the term lesbian. I think that's really interesting. Oh, and they go on to say, appreciating the little things. That one touched me quite a bit because it shows you that whatever walk of life we come from, we like to see ourselves represented one way or another. And for someone to get something out of that, that lesbian isn't like a dirty word, to just hear a song where people are proudly singing lesbians, you know, is a great thing. So I'm glad that that meant something to her. And this one, I love this one. I am proud we are in the same pirate boat. I love that because at times you may feel like the world's going crazy and so much of what LGB people have fought for over the years is either being appropriated or being taken away. It can feel quite lonely, maybe you feel isolated, but there is in fact a whole pirate boat waiting for you. And I love that because it's like, okay, we're the pirates now, right? We're the gender pirates, but we've got our own boat and we're kind of like the rebels now, as we were back then. It's kind of crazy how it's gone, but here we are. Okay, some people, they were suggesting that maybe we could do a flash mob with the song where we all just jump up somewhere and start singing lesbians, bison, gays, which I think is a great idea. Obviously, we'll have to wait till all this COVID business is under control. Or we could do something online maybe, where we have all these different voices from around the world all joining in a celebration of same-sex attraction. I just love that idea. So hopefully we'll be able to pull that off somehow. Okay, so obviously there were some comments about people who didn't appreciate it. One was from a podcast called What the Trans? I love that name, which basically said, all your songs are shit. You cannot sing, you're not funny. And I'm like, okay, well, thanks for that. Plenty of other stuff you can watch online, you know. Have a nice day. And there was one comment which really, I mean, this one cracked me up. this one's gonna get his own video, so I won't go into detail. But they said, just a reminder that trans people existing doesn't make your genitalia fall off. Which is hilarious. So as I said, that one's gonna get its own video. And of course, Pink News had plenty to say about it, because any opportunity to slag off the LGB Alliance, you know, they won't miss it. So they put an article up called LGB Alliance releases toe-curlingly embarrassing sea shanty. And I was like, okay, here we go. And I read it, expecting they would just be slating it no end. But actually, it was quite positive. They even printed the full lyrics, so thank you. They mentioned my puberty blocker song, and they're saying mrmenno is critical of these blockers being given to trans children, which is true. Although I'd argue that there's no such thing as a trans child, but that's a whole other topic. They said that I satirized Sam Smith's coming out as non-binary. Yeah, I did. I think he's either completely deluded or he's selling out. And then they quoted a few things from my interview with Graham Linehan, not the bits where I was holding Pink News responsible for being very divisive in the community and for the rubbish that they're spouting. They didn't quote that. But they quoted some other stuff, which, yeah, absolutely, was good stuff. So thank you, Pink News. And thank you, Maggie Baska, who is the person who wrote the piece. They posted it on Twitter, of course, and then there were some trans accounts. And they were slagging it off. Fair enough, you know, that's to be expected. But somebody said it was anti-trans propaganda. And I think that's kind of crazy, because the song doesn't mention the word trans. It's not about anything trans. It just says, hey, there's no shame in being same-sex attracted. And, you know, people take issue with that, which is nuts. So obviously there were some of those comments, and it was a sea shanty made by straight people because they have no sense of fun. And it's just like, wow, the lengths they go to just put it down and not see it for what it really is incredible. But what was good to see is that a lot more people went, hey, Pink News, like, what's your problem? So somebody wrote this, here's a positive song about lesbians, bis and gays, and you're having a hissy fit, your homophobia is showing. And I think that kind of sums it up. And it's also kind of funny because Pink News often accuses the LGB Alliance of being obsessed with trans, and that they're only talking about trans stuff, and then they do something that doesn't even mention the word, and then they get ridiculed for that, so you can't win. And I think that's a lesson to learn with all this, is you just can't win. No matter what you say, it's wrong, and it's transphobic, and you're anti-trans, and that's it. What's kind of sad, though, is I had a friend message me, whom I've known since 2009, who just went, you're anti-trans. He said, you know, I haven't watched the sea shanty yet, but are you anti-trans? Why are you doing this? And I'm like, okay, hold on. You've known me for at least 12 years. You come at me saying, are you anti-trans? And you haven't even watched the video for the sea shanty. You know, that kind of shows the level of debate. I'm doing the crap fingers, yes. I was like, really, queen? So we got into some argy-bargy. But again, as soon as somebody puts you in the transphobe or anti-trans box, you can't get out of it, no matter what you say, because everything you say gets turned around into something that's somehow transphobic or anti-trans. And for this to come, not just from some, you know, unhinged Twitter troll, but from an actual friend, was a bit shocking. What he said was that I'm part of hysterical efforts to fracture the community. And I'm anti-trans, obviously. I asked him to explain what he meant by anti-trans, and he never did, so it wasn't a great debate. I'd like to think he's coming from a genuine place where he's concerned about something. Obviously, I've offended some sort of sensibility that's important to him. I didn't really manage to find out what that was. It wasn't much of a conversation, and it just ended up with him going, "Take care." Okay, well, you know, my door is always open. I think there's three ways that people who know me can look at this. If they're like, "Oh, what's he doing? Why is he making this content?" The first option, I guess, is Menno's completely lost the plot and become unhinged. The second option is you can think, Menno has his heart in the right place, he's just not going about it the right way. And the third option is, maybe this guy has a point. So I guess those are three ways that you can approach what I'm doing from. But on the other hand, you know, obviously in life people come and go. Somebody contacted me who lives in Australia, who saw my interview with Glinner, Graham Linehan, and she's like, "Hey, were you that guy that I went to the movies with back in 99 in Leicester Square?" And this was true. So she was on her own and I was there with a friend, and then we got talking, we watched the movie together, we went out for drinks. Anyway, so now we're messaging again, which is really cool. And because of that, I've also rekindled a friendship with somebody else that I used to be quite close with. So that's really nice. So, you know, I knew before I started getting vocal about this stuff that some people wouldn't appreciate it. Also people that I know, and that I maybe losing some friends, and that's just how it goes. It's a risk I took because I thought I can't be quiet. Obviously, you never quite know which people you're gonna lose. But over the last few months, I've also met a few really incredible people, which has been amazing. So for anyone who is scared about losing friends, yes, it may well happen, but there's also a community, a small community out there that is more than happy to welcome you with open arms. And this all reminds me of this Bette Midler song, Friends.
But you got to have friends. The feelings are so strong. You got to have friends to make that day last long. I had some friends, but they're gone.
Okay, so what's next? I'm currently working on a Magdalene Burns tribute. Magdalene's videos, she's no longer with us, I'm afraid, and I think if she were still around, she'd be absolutely having a field day with everything that's going on. Her videos for me were a real eye-opener, for her to speak so clearly and plainly. She didn't mince her words, and also the things that she pointed out, the homophobia and misogyny that seems to be at the heart of a lot of the craziness that we're seeing. So I wanted to do something to pay tribute to her. And I've put together a music track, and then I've put her voice to it, so she's talking over the music, and then I have a chorus of women basically singing, "Woman, adult human female, woman, adult human female." And I didn't want my voice in it because I'm a guy and this is all about women celebrating women and her legacy. So I found women in the States, in the UK and in Australia. They've all contributed vocals for this, and I just absolutely love working on this and getting these vocals and then literally weaving them together, you know, into a piece that reclaims the dictionary definition of a woman. So I'm hoping to put that on YouTube by the end of this week. I'm also working on a song about top surgery. That's quite a hard one to work on, because as I'm doing research for it, I'm coming across a lot of quite heartbreaking stories and photos. It's not funny in any way. I'm just trying to understand what is it that is driving these girls to want to pursue top surgery. Top surgery, obviously, is gender woo-woo speak for the amputation of perfectly healthy human body parts. What is driving it from their end? And also looking at who are the surgeons providing these services, particularly female surgeons. There's a lot more videos that I want to make, and if you think that I'm doing a good thing and you want to support me in doing that, I have a question for you, which is very awkward to ask, so I'm just gonna blurt it out. Can you please support me financially?
Your love gives me such a thrill, but your love won't pay my bills. I want money. That's what I want.
I've created created a Patreon page with 5 different packages, so you can choose from 5 different levels of financial support. I have the Beautiful Stranger package, the Dancing Queen package, the Sugar Daddy package, the Fairy Godmother package, and the Big Spender package. Obviously, those are my favorites. Every package comes with its own benefits that you get for contributing from as little as $2 a month. I know times are hard, but obviously we're up against some serious craziness and we need to fight back and push back as much as we can. One of my patrons said the other day that they can't speak out themselves because that would put their job at risk. But they said that by supporting me, they feel like they are doing their bit. So if you're in a similar situation or you're thinking, I really like what Menno was doing and I want to support him, then please do go to my Patreon page. I'll put a link below the video. Sign up and let's get more work out there. Okay, I'm gonna get back to working on the Magdalen Burns tribute. So my fellow gender pirates, I will leave you with these parting words. Homosexual is not a dirty word. Bisexual is not a dirty word. Same-sex attraction is not a dirty thing. And saying this is not anti-trans. So let's keep it real and keep smiling. Arrgh!